This week at Interior. Secretary Jewell this week announced $102 million in coastal resilience grants. Those are aimed at helping Atlantic Coast communities protect themselves from future storms like Hurricane Sandy. The grants will fund more than 50 projects, everything from stabilizing beaches, strengthening coastal wetlands that act as a barrier to storm surges, and restoring natural areas that provide a habitat for wildlife, all the while creating hundreds of jobs in local communities. Jewell made the announcement in Jamaica Bay Wildlife Refuge outside New York City, where she joined Youth Corps members and the National Fish and Wildlife Foundation in projects that will help keep stormwater at bay. It's all part of the Obama administration's Climate Action Plan commitment to make communities more resilient in the face of future storms. That Climate Action Plan also calls for more domestic clean energy to reduce carbon pollution and create American jobs. And this week, the secretary joined Governor Deval Patrick to announce the nation's largest offshore wind energy area available for commercial development, a 742,000-acre zone 12 miles off the coast of Massachusetts that more than doubles the federal offshore acreage available for utility-scale wind energy projects. Before the announcement, Jewell and Patrick toured the Wind Turbine Testing Center in Boston, where engineers and scientists are exploring innovative technologies to help capture the potential of wind energy to power homes and businesses along the Atlantic coast. Researchers have discovered razorback suckers, an endangered fish species, spawning in the lower Colorado River within the Grand Canyon. The detection of larval razorback suckers, believed to have been missing from the Grand Canyon since the 1990s, provides evidence that these fish may be naturally reproducing. Unique to the Colorado River Basin, razorback suckers were once widespread and abundant, but until the recent exciting discovery, the species had not been seen in over 20 years. Find out more at DOI.gov. Another discovery, this one 3 million years in the making, at the Bureau of Reclamation's Elephant Butte Reservoir in New Mexico. That's where campers stumbled on the skull and tusks of a Stegomastodon, a sort of prehistoric elephant that stood about 9 feet tall and weighed about 5 tons. The remains were taken to the New Mexico Museum of Natural History in Albuquerque, where they'll be studied for the next several months. You can see the whole story at usbr.gov. And new images this week of the historic presidential trip to Indian country. President Obama and the First Lady visited the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe last week during their annual Cannonball Flag Day celebration. He's only the fourth sitting president to ever visit a reservation. That's this week at Interior.